instructor Frankston and Mikey Frankston. My name is Bruce Cole.
This is Daniel Wong. I'm the instructor at the Melbourne City Academy. Chris Cook, that's okay. Basically, teaching time to time in the city.
Well, I say to end that, and I'm trying to close that quick.
So, did I have a dog when you ran down right?
Standardize, because it's like a story about a farmer, and he has a cow, and then he has a cow and who has, you know, a litter of cows and things, you know, and then when it starts spread to the next village, and the story all changed, right? So we want to standardize your teaching, and also that. In my traveling, and I deal with a lot of professional fighters, a lot of martial artists who has been involved in martial art all their life, 30 years, 40 years, and they come to me and they say, how can I improve? I say, the only way you can improve is go back to the basics, because you find you're stuck there because your basic is not good. So the basic is very important. So today we devote all our time to look into why we do things this way, why we don't do things this way. Maybe a different interpretation from your instructors, and because everybody has a favorite, but I want to standardize certain things. You're free to ask questions. I'll be moving around with you anyway. Firstly, we want to go to the principle. Well, in Wing Chun, let's look at the self-defense aspect. In self-defense, you need to be able to apply in situations. You know? So the Wing Chun principle, what's the most important thing about Wing Chun principle? Yeah, firstly, is to not fight force with force. Not fight force with force, right? So, secondly, is to guard your center. So once you guard your center, you'll be able to use two arms at the same time. Yeah. Thirdly, you learn to fight on the blind side, right? So I will explain all this with you. Go through the blind side. And fourthly, you watch the elbow, you check the elbow, and then also, and there's also some other little rules that you want to apply in special situations, right? So I don't want everybody to catch cold, you know. So I'll run through some simple movement first, and then I'll show you exactly why it has to be done a specific way, why it's not done another way, right? Okay, so now let's line up. Let's space out a bit. Then we're going to do checking with the Pak Sao and punch, right? Checking with the Pak Sao and punch. And then we want to do checking with the Pak Sao and punch, right? So you go one, right? Two, right? So one, two. Now, so when you do this, your punch is going in the center, right? But your Pak Sao is coming diagonally across. So you're using the palm as a guide to your punch, right? So your Pak Sao is going across your body, okay? And your punch is in the center, right? So how is that applied is, right? How is applied is, you pass out diagonally across, and then you punch from here, right? Okay? Now, then if you want to follow through from here, then you go one, right? The second one is straight. So the first pass out is different to the second one. Because you already deflect, you already deflect that punch over there. Right? You see that? Right? Right? You understand? Okay? So the second pass out, the first pass out is diagonally across your body, and you punch on top, the elbows on top of your palm, okay? The second one is here, right? So because you have to get a little bit of room, so what you do is you shift, you step, right? You step over there. Right? So after the first one, the second one is in the middle. Alright? So can we pair up and try this out? Alright? Okay. You can't do it. I want you to understand it, and then we'll build it on anyway, so you will have time to practice, right? Now, remember I said the five things about you don't fight force with force. You got the center, you watch the elbow, you check the elbow, you know, and you move to the fight on the blind side, right? So you cover, right? So don't mix this movement to a lapsout, right? This is still a paxout movement, right? You got a diagonal paxout, you got straight packs up, but you can also do it like this. You can do it with a laps out. That's a laps out movement. Right. So to fight on the blind side, you line up your body, you line up your center line parallel to his shoulder. That's on the blind side. You're controlling the elbow. So that this arm is useless. Right? This arm is useless because if this arm crosses, you can pin him up. So you know, you attack his balance because you're checking his elbow, so you're attacking his balance, you're creating opening. If his arms cross, you pin him up, right? So from here, you can also do this. Right? But that is a lapse out. So if you practice this, it will look different. If you practice, you happen to be in front of a mirror, which is not the best way to train, but in the beginning, you need to have a look at what you're doing, right? So you go from here, check, punch, right? Without moving the body, say, check, punch. Laps out, punch. It's not on top of this one. So sometimes you get the two mix up, right? You go here, that's one move. Here, that's another move. So if you use your footwork, so one, two, right? So this is diagonal. This point here is diagonal to your target. Diagonal to your target. The other one is check here. You're still on the same line. You haven't moved to the blind side yet. Alright, so you have to distinguish the two. Alright? So let's do the two. You know, let's do this one And also, let's do this one. Okay?
So you keep it in mind, but we keep adding on anyway. So just get closer so you can hear and you can see. Now, another thing about, say, if you want to use your technique or you have to save your life or you do something, so you have to use it effectively, right? Effectively. So you have to think about how to finish it off and what do you do to get what result. So the target area that you actually strike is here, right? Target area, and then if you do a lap saw here, right? Or here, right? Okay. Then because you're attacking on top, so his attention is all focused on top. So from here you can strike here, right? You can attack here. Or you can attack here, right? So you have those, or you can, you know, look straight in here, right? So you can have those. Right? So you're finishing, you think about the finishing, how do you finish in your technique? How do you make your technique more effective, right? So you aim at the pressure points on the side here, right? And the ribs, floating ribs here. You know, you attack his balance, you know, sweep, attack his balance, right? Or you attack, you know, cut his leg, and then you can, you know. So you start it off, you watch the elbow, right? So from here, so you here. So you force, right? Then you can finish it. All right? Okay. Now, the other one that I want you to do is, say you, a cross arm, say you started with a cross arm. So a punch comes in, right? So you last, right? Now, if you don't move your body, the last arm is going to be the center. You practice without moving your feet. So last I'm going to say that your punch is here. So this point in here had a relationship. So you got from here, right? A relationship here, punch up, laughs up, and then a punch up here. Right? And then, yeah, you can, all right? So you go from here, laugh, right? Laugh, punch. And then with the step, lap, right? So this one is on the central line. This one's on the center line. This right in the center. So don't do a lap out across. Why? Because you missed it, you're going to be wide open. This one, if you miss it, your arm is still coming in the center. So that lap out is in the center. Right? Punch here. Right? Check here. Right? And then you see here. Then you come back, that's equal. So you go one, two, right? Three, four, right? So, right? One, two, right? Three, four, right? Okay. how it applies. Once you understand how it applies, then you would know how should you train it, right? You started off, so to form a fist, it has a sequence. You gotta curl up the fingers first, then you put your thumb over the first finger, right? Form a fist, right? And you pull back. This is the elbow strike, and also this pull back is that when somebody grabs your arm, right? You pull back. Instead of just turn, pull back, then you. So expose his elbow, so you can check the elbow. So you, when you do this, the turning and pulling back has the meaning. And this is a strike, right? Somebody grabs you, you strike, right? And then you slip out, right? So you go from here, that defines the central line, right? But when you're away from the center, there'll become a central line. That means you'll be able to use two arms at the same time. And then from here, right, you punch, and this Huan Shao is a Lao Shao, right? It's rely on speed. So you throw a punch, I throw a punch, and he pop. So you rely on speed to get around. So when you do it, you do it with speed, right? No. Of course, you have to learn the rotation, but it's rely on speed, and also you don't stick to the arm. You don't stick to arm, right? Because you cannot turn, right? You get away from the arm, right? You understand? Right? So the punch, the Huan Shao, rely on speed, okay? Right? Rely on speed. And then the Tan Shao, later on, we introduce you the Bong Shao. Tan Shao, when the finish of the Tan Shao, you turn it around, is the Bong Shao. Tan Shao, turn around. And also, when you get to the end of the Tan Shao, you have that Huan Shao, that rotation. It's also rely on speed, right? So you got punch comes in, right? Rely on speed, right? Not sticking around. You understand? Right. So it's about speed, about you get away from the arm and you're catching it again. Same thing with the punch, right? Then after the Tan Shao, you have the Wu Shao. Wu Shao, you want this elbow away from the body so that the force comes in will escape here. But your elbow in the body, then force comes in, it'll push you off balance. You understand what I'm saying? Right? So if you have this Wu Shao here, this Wu Shao here, right? See the elbow, right? You either collapse or the force will go directly to the body. There's nowhere to go. Alright? Now, so Wu Shao, you stop people coming in. Force, escape here, force nowhere to escape. So that's why your elbow, this line is away from the body, this line, away from the body. But you don't want to do that because you're not protecting your body. You want to find the optimal position to place your elbow, right? So you bring it in, right? If you understand, but not like that, so that the force can escape. right? Then you just, the Phục Sáu does not start from here. I mean, that doesn't do anything. The Phục Sáu start from out there, right? So you just relax and then get your elbow out there. Now, the difference about this Huyên Sáu and the Tan Sáu, the Huyên Sáu is this rely on power. So punch comes in, rely on power. Right? A Phục Sáu, see? So if your Phục Sáu is this is level, then the punch will come to your body. So you do that, there's a tunnel here. Keep the punch away from you, right? But you want to get from one side to the other side. You want to get from one side to the other side? Right? But rely on power. It's different than the Lao Sao. You get around and catching it again. This one, you're pushing the arm. Alright? Okay? Alright? So same thing, the Wu Sao comes back. And you have the diagonal Park Sao. Diagonal Park Sao actually pushing the other person, the arm away from you. Right? So usually, the way you're using the diagonal Park Sao is you do a kick, right? You do a kick because you are keep that distance. Just because you won't be able to punch him, you won't reach him, right? So the Park Sao punch that we're using is this one. You actually draw him in. It's this one. It's not this one. All right? Okay? I mean, if you are here today, just learn one thing. I think it's worth it. Yes? Yeah. We do it. Yeah. So diagonally, Park Sao usually doesn't have. Yeah, usually is for you to do a kick. Right? Usually. Alright? Okay. So you got a Park Sao and a strike. Same thing, once you strike, you're using speed. Okay? So why don't we pair it up and try this out? Just the punch and the person do a Park Sao and you have punch, right? Right? So you're using speed. And then, or he does a punch, right? You do a Tan Sao. Right? And then, a Phục Sáu, you do a Huyên Sáu. Okay? So why don't we try that? And then we add on something to it later. Alright? So you rely on speed. Alright? But with the Phục Sáu,
rely on. Sorry.
When you throw a punch, somebody pushes you. You don't fight for it at all. So you rely on speed. Come down, let go, and catch it again. Okay, now, so the next part. From after you did that Park Sao, the next part is here, right? That's the Gam Sao. Gam Sao is to deal with kicks, and then you got the reverse, you got the palm strike, right? So a kick comes in, Gam Sao, so you do this slightly in front of you. Right, you do it. Right. Okay.
So you move the back foot and make this your stance. So you go thumbs up. And then you check the nearest elbow. Check the nearest elbow. Okay. And if you do it on the other side, check the nearest elbow. Okay. Right. So you check the nearest elbow. Okay. And then this is to break out of a grip. That, yeah. You do it reverse. Right. And then when you do the advanced ceiling top form, that you got this one. You bring this up, and you swing around, which is right. You swing around. So you move your feet behind here. Right. So you got right here. Bring this up. So you swing this. Grab hold of me. Okay. So you bring this foot behind. Here. Send it the other side. Alright. Okay. Then, after this, you come back here. So that is that, you know, the in the beginning I said you got Park Sao, but you can also replace it with that Jat Sao punch. Right? That Jat Sao punch. It comes from here. And Biu Ji down. Right? Same thing. This Xun Sao is rely on speed. Right? So now what we're going to do is we're going to practice that kick. Right, you practice that kick and trap the elbow. Right, trap the elbow. Okay. Okay. See when you block the kick from inside, right? When you block the kick from inside, usually you do a kick to stop him charging into you because you're on the inside, you're not on the blind side, right? But you know, if you block the kick from outside, then you're on the blind side, and then you can. Right? So you got him here on the inside. So you do a kick. So one of the rules is that same thing when you knock a punch from inside, you usually do a kick. So he throws a punch, you usually do a kick to give you time to move to the blind side. And then you line up from here. Okay. Now, a lot of you, when you take the side step, you bring your foot too close to the front foot. So you should, because you have to move up a little. So you should bring your foot a bit further from this foot, right? So further from this foot, right? Or not too close, then you cannot find your balance, right? So further from this foot. And then you check. Okay. So you do it from the inside. Oh. Why'd you run into me? Okay. Alright. Okay. So try to bring your foot further back instead of here. Further back here, and then you shift away, and you can go from.
But when you do on the outside, you can still kick. You can still kick. When you put your guard up, right? So you think about 6 points. The fingertip, the elbow, the shoulder, the hip, the knee, and the toe. These 6 points should be pointing to the target, your opponent, right? The 6 points. Okay. So when you turn the other side, right, you turn the 6 points, your weight always seems to be in the middle, right? So you get 50-50 distribution most of the time. Then you can use both feet at the same time, right? Okay? So the fingertip, the elbow, the shoulder, the hip, the knee, the toe, the 6 points, all right? Now, when you move forward, you can use the neutral stance, except you're facing this direction, as your front stance. You don't need to go like this, right? You can actually use your neutral stance, right? In your neutral stance. So when you go forward, you use your neutral stance as your front stance, or you can, you know, slightly turn the foot slightly over, then you will be right. Okay. So a lot of you that when you do the side step, you go too far this way, right? So you shoot. So you run. Okay. So every time you move one foot, the other foot must follow, right? So remember the Rocky movie that he has a rope. That's rubbish. That's rubbish because those guys, they, you know, it's done by movie people. They don't know how to fight. If you really want to, you put a stick. Say your stance, most of your stance has to be at a certain width. Right? Put a stick attached to a rubber. So when you move, then you always keep that distance. Not a rope that you, I mean, once you get close, too close here, you're going to lose balance, right? So you see, the reason that we do this is not a step. This is a transitional, that you transfer your weight. You transfer your weight, also you cover your center, right? You transfer your weight, but most of the step that you do, right, have to keep a certain distance, so you get better balance. All right. So we go back to this cylindrical form that we got. After you did, this jut, Bill and Gum and Lee. Right? Then you got a Park Sao that goes across, palm strike. Right? Park Sao goes across, palm strike. So this one, it can be used as, right, punch underneath, and then you use the lap saw. Remember the lap saw? It's going in the center, not the karate kid lap saw, like a wiper. That doesn't do anything, right? Lap saw, always going. Right? So you go from here, lap saw, and so if you didn't move your feet, then you don't move your body, so you go pak sao, lap sao, punch, and a pak or jab, and punch. Right, so you would have pak sao, lap sao, punch, right? So this punch is diagonal, this target is diagonal to your lap sao. Your lap sao is in the center here, and jab, and punch, right? But unfortunately, we move our body and then we lost the form, right? So you go, pak sao, right? Pak sao, punch, right? Lap sao, or pak sao, punch, right? Lap sao, punch, and then you come back and center. But if you use your feet, right? So this point creates a target there, or the target there. All right. So you get, you create, you use your movement, your control to create the target. Half cell, last cell, and. All right, so let's try this one. Gang sao, tan sao, and then, you got tan, gang, tan, right, and then tan, gang, tan, right, and then, okay. Now, so when you do the tan, it's in the middle, in the center of your body, right? So you got punch comes in, tan, and then a punch comes here, right? And, you know, so you got must face the point of contact, right? So you got tan, gang, or you got a punch from low and then a punch from high, right? Now, but if you want to do a counter attack, so the punch would, if you don't move your feet, the punch would look like this, right? So you go tan and the punch would be over there. Right? So a tan, punch would be over there. Or a gang, a punch would be over there. Gang, punch would be over there. So you got from here, tan, right? So the punch would be over there. So gang, a punch would be over there. Alright? So punch and here. Alright, so you tan here, punch would be over there. Okay? So it's not on the same line, or it's not like that. Because it would not stop anything. You must face the point of contact. When you turn, you must face the point of contact. Right. So let's try. So he throws the round punch, tan, and then a gang. Right. Just try this first. Right. So you must face the point of contact. Right. Tan, gang, gang. So same thing when you do that rotation, you use speed. So you go from here, right? So when you take an arm across your face or your body, you always want to control the opponent's fist. So to control the opponent's fist, you must control the wrist.
So you take it, from here.
Okay. Now, go back to when we did this. So he throws a round punch here, right? So you do that, right? Okay. Now, then when I want to take this arm across, I actually pull it, into here. And here, so. But if you don't know this technique, it doesn't matter. But if you know, that's how you use this. Just diagonally across. All right. So let's go back to Han, Gang. Han. Remember that whenever you take an arm across, you must control the wrist. Right? So he throws a round punch right, from here. Right? Now you pull this to hit your shoulder here. Right? But because you are an intelligent person, you're not going to let him do that. So you push this arm up, so this will pass you. Then you catch the elbow. Control his balance. So you go from here. Right. Okay. So you go from here to right. Then you push this arm out. Up. Right. The chin's out. Up. Right. But see how I control? I don't go here. Then I hit it. Right. So one. Right. Two. Three. One, two, three. So same thing that when you do the hands out, you can do that, right? Your hands out. Oh, one other thing, right? When you turn to your right, you use your left foot, right? See my left foot. So I turn to the right. I use my left foot. Step with my left foot. Turn to the left, step to the right. So you go, right? Okay? Now. So, but don't turn first. Don't turn. Then you're going to pull this into a hitch. After you take him across, then you turn. Right? You want to turn to the outside. Right? Here. And you turn. Okay? So Tan, catch the wrist, same thing, you push this out, then you turn, right? Don't turn, then you're in trouble. Tan, turn, you're in trouble. Tan, catch it. Then turn, then you're not in trouble. Alright?
Sigal, if you catch it on the wrist first,
yeah.
And is it okay to do it straight away then?
Oh yeah, yeah, you can do this. You can do this. Or you can actually, there's many ways you can do it. So you can from here, you can actually do a lap sao. But the one that I show you is the Pak Sao Chun Sao. Alright? But you still have to say, okay, say you do a lap sao, you still have to bring this across before you turn. You cannot turn. The same time you bring it across, that's where everybody make mistakes. Because it's sequence. Life is sequence. It's like today is Sunday, yesterday is Saturday, tomorrow is Monday. So if you muck up the day, you're going to be in a lot of trouble, right? Or if you drive a car, you know, you should stop the car, you know, turn off the engine, you know, undo your seatbelt before you get out of the car, all that. It's sequence, right? So the sequence is that, right? And also direction.
Right? You do a laps out, still you have to, you have to, you have to bring the arm across before you turn. That is the sequence, right? So you do a pass out, same thing, you bring the arm across before you turn. All right? You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
Are you going to bring the arm across past you before you turn? Same thing if you have a low punch, right? Gun. You bring that across before you turn. You don't turn the same time you you bring the arm across. That is the sequence, right? And then also, if you want to turn to the right, you move your left foot first. You turn to the left, you move your right foot first, right? So that is the sequence, all right? Okay, so you go from here, right? A round punch comes in, you do it slowly first, right? There's no rush, okay? Olympics next year. Yeah, you still got a long way to go, right? 13, 14 months to go to get into Olympics. So you go from here, you catch it, push it into here, but same time you push this up, so that means it will be outside of your arm. Then you watch the elbow, right? Your eyes are watching four things. Balance, opening elbow, arms crossed. That's what your eyes are watching, right? So one of those things here, right? So you go from here, right? So the, right? Once you pull across, see the elbows here? So you catch the elbow, and you knock him out from here, right? You understand, right? So if you slow it down, right? Hopefully, every one of you will get a video, right? Otherwise, we'd be very upset with personal here. Because it's very important, the basics, very important. So, see, I don't turn yet, right? You push this across. The arms across it. Then you turn, then you hit. Right? You have tons of time. Then you hit, right? You cannot mix up, you cannot muck up the sequence. Alright? So one, two, then you turn. Right? Then you turn. Alright? So same thing. Gun, then you turn. Take this across first, then you turn. Not together. It looked like together, but it's not together. Same thing. Turn and punch. Turn and punch. Not punch and turn. Then he'll hit you. Right? Because he's already hitting you, right? So turn and punch. Right? So you must defend first. Then you put in the punch. Same thing. Park and punch. Right? You must park first. And then punch. All right, that sequence, right? But because you're doing it so fast, you know, sometimes you get confused that which goes first. But it's the defense goes first. Right? It's the defense goes first. All right, all right. So let's do it slowly with your partner. A round punch, right? So one, two, right, and three. Then once you're in there, you recognize you can do this, you can do this, you can do whatever you want. Okay. Inside here, right? So you go from here. Okay. One. So you got to, see if this arm is already stuck, see what you're trying to do is, if you stop it temporarily, then you bring this arm across. But if this arm is already stuck and then you do that, you know, you might be in trouble, right? So if you don't feel comfortable with this one, right, you can come from here. You attack on the elbow, right? So it is a lops out, strike, and the strike. So you go from here, up. Okay? Or, right? Same thing, right? Okay? So you go here. So you have, right? And also, you can also take this across, right? So you take this across, right? So from here, you take this across. Right? Same thing, you have to take it across before you step. So from here, you take this across. So that's your variation. So you have to decide what technique you're going to use, right? So you can stay in the inside, or you can take this across, right, using a gun. Take this across, or you can take this around. So don't worry about the power, you just do the movement first, right? You just do the movement first, right? Then you worry about the power. So you understand that Lao Sao is relying on speed. And the Fok Sao is relying on the strength of your elbow. So the Bong Sao and the Tan Sao is just in reverse. Okay. So once you understand the application, then you know that how you going to train, right? And then you use the training in the Silim Tao, apply in your techniques. Right. Yes?
One question. Yeah. What's the application of the pump and up?
Oh, there's a pump strike.
Pump strike, and then
yeah. You just bring your arm up, that's all.
Just like to the pump strike down and then up.
No. You strike and then you're just finishing off. That's it, finish. Right. You're just finishing off to bring your fist back.
Because it looks like up.
No. Finish. Okay? You just bring your arm back. That's all. Or you can do it down here if you want. Right. You understand?
Yeah.
Right. I can tell elevation. Okay. All right.
So the bones out and the tongues out is, you know, if you turn this, right? So the tongues out is like that, right? Bones out, right? So it's your fingers, it's your distance. The distance of here and here is the same.
So maybe you show from the side too, because a lot of beginners are too close.
Yeah. So it's here. Here. It's the same distance. Okay? Alright? Yes, not here. Here. Bones out. Hands up.
Strike.
Okay.
So go?
Yeah.
This is the when you get into the
yeah.
Here. Yeah. Do you like scoop it out here or is it like straight
through? Yeah, from underneath and then
so it comes out.
Yeah, comes out, right? And then out. Right. Okay. Underneath. Okay.
So,
yeah.
How do you direct the breath into the movements during the form?
You breathe out. You breathe out when you strike, when you use force. When you breathe out, right? Just like, you know, in all other physical movements, you breathe out. You always breathe out when you use force. So when you do the Silim Tao, you can do it many ways, you know, you can do it just to understand the movement first, get the movement right, then you condition your muscles and so on, then you go into to get some energy, right, get your energy, then you get into maybe a bit of speed, a bit of power, right, and also because, and you identify the direction of your movement. So when you apply it, you must have that direction because it's separate from your footwork. Your silimkap does not show you footwork. So that's why when you apply it, you must understand the tansao